principal goal of therapy in patients with PV is to reduce the risk of thrombotic events. That is the number one problem that we encounter with patients with PV. Patients are divided into two risk groups, those who are at high risk of a thrombotic event and those who are at a low risk but still have a risk of a thrombotic event. Patients who are over the age of 60 or who have ever had a thrombotic event are at high risk of a thrombotic event. And patients under the age of 60 and who have never had a thrombotic event are at lower risk of having a thrombotic event. Thrombotic events in these patients can occur in the form of heart attacks, strokes, and clots in abdominal blood vessels, which are very uncommon. First and foremost, we always worry about the hematocrit and optimizing that to lower the risk of thrombosis. Beyond that, however, I think it's very important that we take into account a patient's symptom burden. Now, patients can have variable symptoms when they have PV. Some patients have little to no symptoms, but some patients have very important symptoms that are debilitating. I think it's important to recognize those symptoms as an important treatment landmark. A patient's risk of thrombosis doesn't necessarily correlate with their symptom burden, and so those two goals are sometimes divergent. We have to be cognizant of that when treating a patient.